Hey, welcome back to the G-Clan. It's been a while since I've made a video. Lately, a friend of mine had provided some deer antlers for me for some antler art I've been working on. Several of the sets of antlers were ones that his wife actually harvested years ago. We're going to take one set of those and turn them into a towel rack for their bathroom or a robe rack, depending on how they want to use it. So let's get started. We're gonna try to figure out what angle to sand the bottom or grind it down to. So we'll take a look at, kind of like to have it tip like this, I think. So hold it in about the orientation I want. Make a line. Probably best to add a little. We'll make a line, we'll add a little block. We won't go this high up on it. We're going to get some height on it. Now we'll start out with that on that one, I think. Look at this one, we'll probably give it a little. We'll do one first and then we'll match the other one. So what I did there was I wanted a flat enough spot where I can bore out, and then we'll epoxy a nut in there so that we can screw it in from the backside. I like to keep the fasteners hidden. I don't like them to go through the antlers. So we'll take a look at this, how this one is, and then we'll try to match up the other one to it. So I got it matched up pretty good. So what I'm gonna do is go over to my disc sander that I was just on, and then I'll create a matching flat spot over here. We'll epoxy a nut in this end and then this end, and then we'll be able to mount it to the board. I think that's going to be the way we want it to look right there. So I've kind of come up with a little system of epoxying nuts into the back of the antlers. I start out with just a regular nut on the bolt that I'm going to use. Then I put a washer. Then we'll put a locking nut on. And I just like the locking nuts just because it's nice to have it, make sure that it doesn't back out. So I'll install one of the nut with the pliers. just to make sure I have a little extra thread on the other side, I just add an extra bolt. The screws and bolts that I got came together from the big box store like that. So I'm just kind of tighten those up. And then that washer with the nut behind it, when I put it in to the antler, it keeps it level with where I flattened it. But we'll do up a few of those right now. Well, I need four for this set, but I think I might be, it's just easier when I mix epoxy to do several at a time. The next step is to bore some holes into the horns in these locations here. For doing something like this, I like to use a self-mixing epoxy. This is an 8-minute epoxy. That way I can put it down directly into the holes. You don't want to fill it completely up because you don't want it oozing out too much. But this way, when you're pushing it in, it mixes it as it goes. It's not quite as messy. And that's how I do that. Well, I picked out a piece of black ash to use for the board on this. So what I need to do now is try to figure out the orientation of the horns. So what I'm going to end up doing is I'll just fasten the one higher one up, and I can rotate them to where I like them. So we'll kind of just even them up on here. Use my square to bring it in from the edge just to see how far it is. Say, let's bring it in like that. Just something that looks good to the eye. Kind of equal distance. Let's go by that. Let's just check the beam part to see how that is. About 3 inches there. About 3.5, but I want to make it look like for the horn tips, I think. Could always bring it out just a little bit, I guess. That's 3 a little more. I think we want to bring it up just a little bit. Bring it up an inch off the bottom there. That's already an inch. I think that's pretty good. I'm just going to make a couple little pencil lines. So I can kind of figure out where to put it back. Now that we got that, I'll take chuck of the same size threaded screw this in here. Get some pliers. Put it just a little bit deeper. So then what we'll do is we'll give that a hit, mark the board, then we'll drill a hole, and that'll be our starting point to figure out which way to orient them. Looks pretty good. Right there, just mark it a little bit better. This way, once used as a robe rack or towel rack in a bedroom or a bathroom, I mean, or in a bedroom for hanging up a shirt or something, we can all these points here you can hang stuff off them because they're all angled up, so or angled in and down. So we kind of get them in the same spot. We'll just make another line down here. That'll get us pretty close. It's supposed to have kind of a rustic look, so you're not going to find perfection. think this is about where we need to be. We're going to ball of whack. And we'll head back over to the drill press. So it's going to end up being a little bit noisy in here, and nobody really likes to sand or watch people sanding, so I'll speed it up from here on out and quiet it down just a little bit. Probably end up with two coats on it. Well, before we get to the assembly, I'm going to flip it over and put my brand on the back. So I never really liked the idea of the little wood plugs that plug up the screw holes. So what I've done, I've come up with my own little plug. I really like how it works out. You put your screw in, it's a metallic screw, metal screw. So what I've done is I cut the bolt heads off of the washers and then attach a magnet on the back and drop them in. And that plugs it up. Makes it look like you got a big old-fashioned square bolt in. Well, thanks for stopping by and checking out the video. I hope you enjoyed the process of making this coat rack, towel rack, whatever they plan on using it for. It's what it will be.